The beauty of physical evidence is that it tells a story. We look at the firearm. We look at the blood. There were cartridges left behind. Projectiles were found within the toilet. Physical evidence cannot lie.
Did you investigate that open window?
Dit is reg, hier. Ek het gekyk of daar enige false entry, iemand wat probeer het inkom in die venster, die vensterraam probeer beskadig is.
Okay. My lady, I did check just to see as to whether there was any false entry, as the witness says it in English, or whether somebody tampered with the window.
Die venster, die vlak is hoog, is op die eerste vlak, en daar was geen manier dat iemand onder, sonder met die hulp van 'n leer, by die venster sou kon inkom.
The level is high, my ladies, on the first floor, and there was no other means in which somebody could have gained access into the house through that window.
That indicates the toilet.
That bewys die toilet, nee.
Dit is reg, hier.
That is correct, my lady.
The damage to the wall behind the toilet, did you
and
see
that? En die beskadiging achter die muur van die toilet, sien jy dat?
Dit is reg, Ele. Dit is die beskadiging van die projektiel van die patrone wat hier gegaan het.
That is correct, my lady. That is the damage which was caused by the projector which went through.
Did you look inside the toilet?
Het jy binnen die toilet gekyk?
Ja, Ele, ek het binnen die toilet gekyk.
Yes, my lady, I did look inside the toilet.
Ele, ja, dit is een foto van die beskuldigde.
Yes, my lady, this is the photo of the accused.
And that photo, the accused had no shirt on.
Dit is reg.
That is correct.
And that's how you found him today.
And that's hoe jy hom hier betrokke dag gevind het.
Ek het hom gevind met sonder hemd.
I found him without a shirt.
Die hoeveelheid bloed wat basis hier in die linkerarm van hom verskyn, is 'n vergelyking wat op die voorkant van hom was.
The amount of blood which is depicted on his body as on the photo was as much as the same amount which was on the front part of his body.
The container with those watches, you saw it on the morning when you entered the scene.
Die eerste stadium toe ons opstap en die deel deurgegaan het, het ek hierdie horlosies waargeneem.
Upon arrival, when we arrived there, when I was proceeding to the main bedroom, I saw those watches.
En het myself gesê, dit is tempting for any person because this is expensive watches. Met die opgang en die uitwys van die toneel aan die fotograaf.
When we were proceeding to the upper level, pointing out the things to the photographer,
het ek hierdie mening van my aan hom gelig en vir hom gesê, ek soek asseblief foto's van hierdie horlosies.
I then asked him, telling him that I need pictures of these watches.
En dat hy moet seker maak dat hulle terwyl hy op toneel is na die horlosies gekyk word en dop.
And I told him to make sure that he keeps an eye on this over the watches.
Ons op daai stadium het ons besluit ons gaan die toneel sluit.
Because at that stage we had decided that we were going to lock up the premises.
Want die bloedanalis Luitenant Kolonel van der Nes was nie beskikbaar vir die dag.
Because by then the blood analyst Kolonel van der Lee van der Nest was not available on that day.
Met die omdraaiele het ek na die boks gekyk, na die horlosieboks gekyk.
When I turned around, my lady, I looked at the box containing the watches.
My lady, the left bottom corner, the watch on the left bottom corner was missing. And I turned around and I asked Warrant Officer Van Staden, did he know anything about this watch? He told me that when the accused sister came up, she requested that she want to take one of the watches. And she took that particular watch. And then one of the forensic experts at the back, I don't know who mentioned that this particular watch, this a green and black one on it in the top right hand corner, was the value between 50 and 100,000 rand. And then I say, you see what I mean? We have to look after the property in this house. While we were all packing up and getting our things ready to leave, Warrant Officer Van Staden came into the garage and he mentioned that one of these watches is missing. And I said, what do you mean? What other watch? There's one missing. He course you hand it over. He said, no, there's another one that is missing. My lady, after the photographer was finished in the bathroom, we allow access to the ballistic expert. I was busy talking on my cell phone, arranging and communicating with some of my superiors and also as well as Warrant Officer Botha, when I heard that the firearm has been cocked. So I turned my head to where the firearm has been cocked to see what is going on. And at that particular moment, the ballistic expert was having the firearm in his hand without gloves. So I stopped immediately talking and I asked him, what are you doing? And then he turned his head to me and I was looking, and then he realized there was no hand gloves on. And then he said, sorry. So immediately I turned around and I also informed Warrant Officer Van Staden of what had happened, and I'm not very pleased with what I've saw.
How do you feel about your ability to observe?
My ability to observe? Let's say, yeah, well, I attended a lot of crime scenes, so I've maybe a bit at average.
Thank you to the watches. You will see that there were, in fact, 9 wristwatches. One was removed by his sister to give to him.
There was 8 watches in the box, and 1 watch lying on the desk. Wasn't it 9 watches?
Yeah, 2 went missing.
In the box.
Now one in the box?
That is the 2 that's not missing. This one we accounted for, as the accused sister took this one. This one is the one that went missing.
And the one on top of the cabinet?
That one, I don't know about.
It's also missing.
I was not informed about it. Nobody informed me.
I see that Mr. Botha was kind enough to give interviews, and he was talking about the bloody shirt of Mr. Pistorius that morning that he had on. What do you say about that?
No, my lady, there was no bloody shirt. It was bare.
Was he all the time without the shirt on?
Without the shirt.
Mr. Van Esbeek, I'm told that you're the last witness today, and I must see if we can use up the court time till 3 o'clock. So I'm just trying to find some more questions. I have no
Yes, Mr. Nell.
Indeed. That is photograph 469. Now, the interesting thing with electronic photographs is that it contains metadata. So I'm going to ask Mr. Moller to see if we can find that, but it will indicate when that photograph was taken. My lady, the metadata, the camera is wrong. It indicates that it's a different year and a different date. It's not the official photographer's camera, so I won't take this further because the date is wrong. They took this scene long before that. So, my lady, I have no further questions.
Watch, like, tweet, post, follow, engage. Channel 199, the Oscar Pistorius trial, a carte blanche channel, only on DSTV.